Welcome to the channel Data Science Demonstrated. I wish you an excellent 2022. In this video, I will rewind back to 2021 and show you the top viewed moments on the channel. This list of top viewed moments is based on YouTube video analytics, and I've compiled them into a list of top 21 data science techniques. These techniques, which is shown right now on the screen, can also be considered as a quick course on data science. This will be a fast-paced video as we have a lot to cover. So fasten your seatbelt, my friends. But do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment on the video. You can also experience some of the techniques which are shown in this video on the channel's website, experiencedatascience.com. So let's get started. This histogram which is shown here is for the price of different brands of cars. And what is better than a histogram? Well, it's the hovering histogram, where you can hover over the bars to see what are the cars behind this histogram bars. Boxplot is a great way to find outliers in a visual way. However, the real magic happens when you overlay the original data points over the outlier boxplot. So here you see the boxplot for the width of the car, and all the points which are outside the vertical lines are outliers. Now these outlier points are shown in green color, and you can hover over the points to see the outlier values. Clustering allows you to find groups or clusters within your data. Here you see the result of clustering on the data related to cars. The X and Y axis have been automatically determined by a decision tree algorithm. Now this helps to automatically choose the best way to visualize the clusters rather than manually selecting the X and Y axis. And it is for this reason this technique is also called clustering with automated visualization. Customer journey helps to understand how the customers interact with your company in a chronological order. Shown here is a customer journey for a car rental company. So for example, we see that the customers start with a sedan and then move towards compact and prime, and then ultimately move towards automatic cars. Such analysis gives us very powerful insights into the customer behavior. Nowadays, there are various channels for marketing, and most of the customers are engaging with your content on multiple channels. A channel transition matrix is a good way to know which channels are more effective than others. Topic detection is a great way to make sense of text data. Here is the result of topic detection on tweets related to the COVID vaccinations. The topic detection algorithm has identified 7 topics which are represented as bubbles. When I hover over the topics, I see the words which are commonly occurring in the topic. So for example, if I take the topic 1, I see the words such as first, got, received, etc. So this topic is about the experience when you receive the vaccination for the first time. Let me start this part with a very messy looking visualization. This visualization shows an analysis of the Airbnb locations in New York, and it looks completely messed up. The more smarter way of doing location analysis is to use point in polygon algorithm. Now this algorithm maps each geolocation to a custom polygon. The polygon can represent some geographic areas. So here is the result of the point in polygon algorithm applied to Airbnb locations in New York. Each polygon is a neighborhood in New York, and the color of the polygon is an indication of the number of Airbnb locations in the neighborhood. Another very interesting application of location analytics is for route or trajectory analysis. The map shown here is the map of Portugal, and the heat map style color shows the common routes taken by taxis in Portugal. We can observe that one of the most common routes taken by taxi is from Mazarelos to Palacio de Cristal. We also see a heat spot in this particular location, but we do not see any incoming or outgoing heat spot. We can zoom into this, and we see that this is a luxury yacht parking place. So this means that the taxis are possibly waiting to drop or pick up the passengers. So this would be a good spot to install an EV charger and to promote green mobility. Location analytics algorithms can also give you an optimal route between two places. So for example, here is an optimal route shown between Musée da Cidade and Livraria Lello in the city of Porto. You can compare this with the actual routes taken by the taxi. For example, here is the route taken by the taxi between these two places, Musée de Cidade and Livar e Lelo, and we can see that this is not an optimal route. Let us now move into time series analysis and look into the seasonality detection algorithm. This particular algorithm helps us to find peaks in the time series data. And a very interesting application of seasonality detection is to find peaks in the retail product sales. On the x-axis, you have the product seasonality, and on the y-axis, you have an indication of the product sales. So for example, if you look into this retail product called Rabbit Night Light, we see that the seasonality is 12 months, which means that the sales peak occurs every 12 months. On the other hand, if you take the product World War II Glider, then the seasonality is shown as 6 months, which means that the sales peak is occurring every 6 months. Let us now get fast and furious with the fast Fourier transformation. The fast Fourier transformation is claimed to be the most widely used algorithm on the planet. And here you see a line chart of the number of 911 calls received by the Montgomery County in the USA. On the x-axis, you have the time, and on the y-axis, you have the number of calls received. Now, just by looking at this graph, it is very difficult to make sense out of it as it is not very smooth and there are lots of variations. So now let us apply the fast Fourier magic. The fast Fourier transformation helps to discover repeating and smooth signals in the time series data. So here is the result of the fast Fourier transformation, which shows a repeating signal which the algorithm has found. Now this repeating signal starts at 6 or 7 in the morning, goes up and reaches the maximum around 18 and 19 hours in the evening. And then it goes down and starts again to repeat itself at 6 or 7 the next morning. Now this information could be very useful for staff planning to ensure that there is a maximum capacity between 18 and 19 hours in the evening. Okay, let's now move to some cutting edge visualization called the racing bar chart. Now this visualization alone is telling you 50 years of film history. You can see the year which is increasing and the category of films which are doing most of the business in that year. Now this kind of visualization is very good to be used in data storytelling. Machine learning is best understood when it is visually shown. Here is the decision tree machine learning model for churn prediction. This decision tree has got various decision paths which lead to an outcome whether churn yes or no. We can use this decision tree machine learning model visually to make and understand the churn prediction. So for example, we can predict for this particular customer and we see that the decision path leads to a prediction that this customer is going to churn. Now such a visual representation of machine learning model and prediction is very useful to understand how machine learning actually works. Getting financial value from any project is very important and machine learning projects are no exception. A ROI or a return on investment calculator for machine learning is very useful to understand the potential financial gains of a machine learning model. Here is the ROI calculator for a machine learning model. It takes the confusion matrix and the associated cost and benefits and then calculates a ROI. Now this is also a very useful tool if you want to convince the financial stakeholders to invest in machine learning projects. A retail company makes forecasts for thousands of products. With so many forecasts, one can easily get lost with the sheer amount of data. Now this is where ABCXYZ analysis helps us to give you a global view. So here is how the ABCXYZ analysis looks like. Here the A, B and C indicates the volume of the product sold and the X, Y, Z indicates the forecasting error. The color indicates the number of products. The darker the color means more number of products. The more products you have on the left hand side, the better it is. Though the forecasting is never 100% accurate, efforts should be made to improve the data and forecasting algorithms for all the products which fall in AY and AZ, as these are the products which have high sales but are also having high forecasting error. Product affinity analysis shows which products are bought together by customers. Now, this visualization shows different products as dots, and the lines between them indicate that they are generally bought together. So, for example, there is a strong affinity between the vintage pack cards and the pack of 12 traditional crayons, which means that customers tend to buy these products together. Let us consider an e-commerce marketplace where the seller puts the products in the marketplace and the buyers, they buy the product. What could be the right price of the product? We can use the description of the product and machine learning algorithms to predict a correct price. Now, this requires text clustering to put products with similar descriptions in one cluster. So here is the result of the text clustering algorithm. We see that the product descriptions such as Nike Woman Athletic Apparel price is formed. Louis Vuitton Men Accessories price is formed. So clearly this cluster is for products where the seller does not want to negotiate on the price. Now once you have determined the cluster, you can use them in machine learning model to predict the price. So for example, we can take a product which is a Louis Vuitton, which is a woman's handbag, and the item description says that the price is formed. We also have the name of the cluster in which it belongs. We can predict the price, and this leads to a price of $1056. So this way of using machine learning to predict price is also called dynamic pricing. Neural networks can be very efficient way for data analysis. So here is a neural network based on the passengers on the ill-fated Titanic. The input neuron corresponds to various fields which are available in the data, and the output neuron corresponds to whether the passenger survived or not. In the middle, you have the intermediate neurons. A blue line is an indication of a positive signal, and the red line is an indication of a negative signal. We see that this neuron is passing a very positive signal to the neuron passenger did not survive. Now let us peek inside this neuron. We see a very high red signal, meaning a negative signal from the input neuron sex is female. This indirectly implies that the sex is male. So this neuron is sending a very high positive signal to neuron passenger did not survive. So this means that if the sex is male, there is a high probability that the passenger did not survive. Now we got this insight by just looking at one single visualization, and this replaces at least about 6 different bar plots to come to the same conclusion. Imagine you are a medical professional and you are using AI for stroke prediction. The AI has predicted stroke for one of your patients, and when you tell this to your patient, he is going to panic. And there are two obvious questions which he will ask. The first, can you explain why the stroke was predicted? And the second, what can be done to avoid it? In order to answer these questions, you will need explainable AI. And one of the widely used techniques for explainable AI is called SHAP, which stands for Shapley Additive Explanations. The SHAP for our stroke prediction is shown below. You see two vertical dotted lines. The left gray dotted line corresponds to an expected probability that a stroke can happen to any patient in the data, and this is at about 50%. The right red dotted line corresponds to our patient, indicating a 74.8% probability of stroke. The horizontal bars represent different factors on how they add up from moving the patient from 50 to 74.8% probability of stroke. So we see that the age is contributing 50% to the probability of stroke. The glucose level is contributing 10%, and the body mass index is contributing 4.4% of the probability of stroke. Now, because we know that the contribution of each factors, we can also use this analysis to advise the patient. Now the age cannot be changed, but if the average glucose level and the body mass index can be reduced, then the risk of stroke can go down from 74.8 to 60%. You might be all familiar with the financial trading line charts, which shows the trend for each cryptocurrency. Now, to analyze them individually can be very cumbersome. However, you can combine them into a single line chart using data science techniques. Now, when I say combining, it is more than just putting all the line charts together. you need to apply a data science technique called scalar algorithm before combining them. In order to better understand the usefulness of the scalar algorithm, let me first show you the combined line chart without a scalar. So shown here is the non-scale price line chart for four cryptocurrencies, the Bitcoin, the Ethereum, the Solana, and the Dogecoin. Now the first observation is that we understand the Bitcoin pattern as it is clearly visible. However, for other three currencies, we cannot analyze them as they are not well represented on this line chart. And the reason is that there is a massive difference between the Bitcoin price and the price of other cryptocurrencies. The Bitcoin price is 10 times more than other cryptocurrencies. Now let us apply the scalar algorithm so that all the prices will be converted between 0 and 100. And here is the scale line chart. Now this chart looks much better as all the four cryptocurrencies are well represented. Now we can use this visualization to get very powerful insights. So for example, we see that the Bitcoin, the Ethereum, the Solana all have got similar trends. The Dogecoin has made a peak, but then the prices are trending down. And such insights are only possible with a scale line chart. Nonlinear correlation matrix is used to measure nonlinear relations in the data. A nonlinear correlation matrix has got numeric field pairs on the y-axis and the most common types of nonlinear correlations on the x-axis. The different types of nonlinear correlations which are commonly occurring are exponentially decreasing, exponentially increasing, logarithmic, second degree parabolic, and third degree parabolic. Now, such a nonlinear correlation matrix helps to better understand the patterns and relations in the data.